This Shotcut Shake Effect tutorial shows you how to create the earthquake effect that you see on the screen right now. There are two methods to apply this type of shake effect. Number one is to use a pre-built filter available in Shotcut, and number two is to create the effect manually using keyframes. And there's actually a third type of shake effect that I show at the end of this video. It's a bit different from the last two, but stick around and maybe that is what you're looking for. For most, method one is the fastest and easiest to apply, but if you want fine grain control over the effect or something a little bit more specialist, then you may choose to use method two. Let's jump over to the computer and start with method one.
First of all, drag your clip into the timeline and then find the point where you want the shake effect to start. When you found that point, then cut with the letter S on the keyboard or this button just here. That will divide your clip into two. Select the part of the clip where you want the earthquake effect to start. Come up to filters, click on the plus, search for size, position and rotate. On the presets, click on the drop down, and you've got two options. You can shake for 1 second with scaled or shake for 1 second unscaled. Scaled will zoom in slightly so you don't get any black borders around the edge, and unscaled will not zoom in, so you do get a little black border around the edge where it shakes. Let me demonstrate both of those for you now. So unscaled first. If I start playing my clip, you can see that it shakes, but there's like a black around the edge. Let me play that once more so you can see there's like a black border around the edge there. If I change that to scaled and then play once more, you see it actually zooms in slightly and for the duration of the clip. Let me show you that once more just in case you didn't see. So it zooms in and shakes so you don't get any black border. Now, if you want the scaled zoomed in version so you don't get the black box around the edge, but you don't want it to zoom in, you want the whole clip to stay kind of looking like it's normal, then the best thing to do is to zoom in on the other part of the clip as well. To do this, take a note of how much it zoomed in here. For me, 114.9. Come over to the other part, add in the size, position and rotate tool, and then match the number that you had here. Now that will zoom in the full video clip, but now when you play through, it will look like it rumbles without zooming in. That may or may not be suitable for your requirements. However, now you've got the choice on what you'd like to do. Now you may be wondering how to get the effect to last longer than 1 second. The easiest way is to cut the clip into multiple segments for each second. So if I go for 1 second there and cut, and then go for 1 second there and cut, and 1 second there and cut. Now when you see, it's got the size, position and rotate on this one. It's got the size, position and rotate on this one, but the preset has disappeared. So apply the preset. Same again for this one, and same again for this one. Now when you play it through, the earthquake effect will carry on rumbling through 4 seconds rather than just one.
If you don't want to cut your clip into 1 second portions, or you can't because it breaks another effect that you already have on the clip, method two is the one you need to use. Now, just before we continue, if we're meeting for the very first time, then my name is Joe and this channel helps YouTubers edit their videos and use free software. If you're creating YouTube videos regularly and not seeing the growth you'd hope for, you're probably missing one or more elements of the video creator framework. You can download the free PDF in the description below to get started. Now, let's get back to the video. To start method two, apply the size, position and rotate filter onto your clip. Use the shake preset just like before. This gives us a starting point and helps speed things up a little. Now you need to copy and paste the keyframe attributes so the effect is extended. This is quite a slow process, but no different from creating other advanced effects in Shotcut. And as far as I'm aware, you have to work on one keyframe at a time, but now you can keep going for as long as you need the effect to last. Now for the third shake effect. It's actually really cool. This effect attaches itself to the music that is playing, so it only shakes or rumbles when the music is loud enough. If you want the details on this Shotcut effect, then please consider liking and subscribing. And before you go, click or tap on the video on your screen right now, and it will continue to help you with Shotcut. I'll see you in the next video.